babies.
My freshman year of college, I had a 40th body count party, so that was quite a while ago.
Your
already
freshman
graduated.
Year of college?
It was 40, and
wait,
then...
hold on, a couple questions.
And I know the other one got more money than you. You know what? I'm going to call them. That's fine, because I'm going to call them.
You got
to
call them.
I'm going to sit on that tonight.
You got to call them.
Wow.
Oh.
Wow.
Wow.
Yay.
Wow. Oh,
so what? This was me.
YouTube. What's going on? WittyP dropping in one time. Today I want to do a reaction to two videos. Yes, I have two videos today that I want to do a reaction to. Both of these videos are exposing female nature. Yes, you know that's one of my strong suits. You know, dating, relationship, female nature, human nature, all that shit. I cover that. This is what I do. But yes, I have two videos I want to do a reaction to, and I'm gonna give you a breakdown of both of the videos. First video is a gal. She's talks about her college experience and her body count. Yes. Oh, I always say, your girl went to college. You know, your girl went to college. Oh, she did some shit you don't want to know about. Trust me. And she talks about her body count. And she talks about her first semester. Oh, shit. What she went through in her first semester. Oh, it's crazy. So she's on the podcast talking about her body count. I'm going to, you know, give some good teacher points about this, you know, with female nature and their body count when they go to college, because I went to a, you know, pretty big university. So I know what goes down on the college campus. And my second video, I want to do a reaction to a guy. He's trying to be a player, but got caught. Yeah, trying to be a player. Nope, got caught, got exposed. And what she said is what women typically do to men once they get caught cheating. So I don't want to give it away too much, but a guy out, you know, trying to be a player, got caught cheating. And what this girl say she's going to do exposes female nature. And I definitely want to cover this, but I'm going to get into the first video with a gal. She talks about her body count in college and talks about what she went through in the first semester. And I'm going to give my feedback after the video to tell you about female nature when it comes to college and going to a big university and what usually goes down. Let's get to the video. What's your body count?
I got to look at my Twitter following. I follow every porn star I fuck.
I mean, but you've probably fucked like civilians.
My freshman year of college, I had a 40th body count party, so that was quite a while ago.
Your
I already
freshman
graduated.
Year of college?
It was 40, and
wait,
then...
wait, hold on, a couple questions there. Was it a semester or quarter?
Oh, honestly, it was the second semester.
Well, how much...
Never forget your
in
40th
your first...
body count. Never forget.
You never do. It's like a birthday, you know? Yeah. It's oh good.
In your first semester, quarter, whatever it was...
Like, I've always been a slut. Like, it's high. It's high. I just love spreading. This is how I spread my love. Like, I fuck. You're my friend. I'm
that's
gonna fuck you.
That's not
the only
thing you're spreading. Jesus Christ.
I've never had an STD in my life ever. I get tested. I've always gotten tested often. I've never. I only fuck like good-looking guys. I'm not like a dirty slut. I'm just like a slut. But anyways, back to the body count.
I'm gonna ask you a string of questions. So before you even step foot on a college campus, what was your body count?
Oh, honestly, not that big. Probably like 7.
Okay. You see what she said? She said she went from only having 7 bodies to 40 after the first semester, first quarter of college. Okay. 33 bodies within, let's just say, a quarter is 3 months. You know, let's just say a quarter is 3 months in school, you know. So she had 10 bodies a month, basically. And she said she even had a 40th, you know, body count anniversaries. So this lets you know, women do not, if your gal went to a college university, she does not know her body count. She does not have a clue what her body count is. She doesn't. This is the best time of your life, actually. Like, if you want to be real, if you went to school, you went to college, it's the best time of your life, because you'll always be trying to get that feel in the back of when you didn't have any responsibilities, we could have fun, you know, you damn near party every day. So this is the best time of your life if you ever went to college. You know, you're in your 20s, you know, this is the best time of your life. It is, if we want to be real, it's the best time of your life. If you went to a, you know, especially a big university, things like that, you know, it's the best time of your life, college is. You know, you didn't have any responsibilities. Your only responsibility was to find out where the next party was and maybe study for a few tests here and there. Your only responsibility, find out where the next party was, what, you know, who throwing the party, what campus is on, you know what I'm saying, and maybe study for a test here and there. That was your only responsibilities in college. We want to be real. So your girl went to college, she has no clue about her body count. She doesn't. She doesn't. And I already video on this. I say, women, they don't know their body count. And men, as a guy, you shouldn't care because she'll never tell you the truth. As a man, you shouldn't even care about a girl body count. You should care about how she act. Just how she act. That's it. That'll let you know if she, you know, she going, she a slut, she this or that. That'll let you know. It will. You know, her actions. Forget what she's saying. Watch a motherfucker. Forget what they saying. So, every girl, she go to college, oh, she gonna rack up the bodies. Oh, she went to college a virgin? Come out a freak. Better believe that. Better believe that. So, women and their body count, never believe it. Never trust it. Don't even ask about it. You know? Don't even ask about it. Because who cares? Who cares? You're going to know she a freak by, you know, her actions, how she, you know, how she talking, how she dressing, things like that. So, body count, who cares? But you see, oh, women that go to college, oh, they rack up their body. They rack up their bodies, for sure. They rack up their bodies. So, and you heard her say, she don't count if it's not good sex. A lot of women, they don't count condom sex, real talk. If it's not skin on skin, women don't count a lot of guys that they had sex with that they may use a condom. They don't, real talk. Especially if it was whack and they had to use a condom. They don't count that. Because if a girl really, always viewed it like this. If a girl really fucking with you, she really like you, she gonna let you slide that condom off. Regardless. Real talk. She really wanna fuck you and she, you know, she really wants you. She gonna let you slide that condom off. Or you could just go raw doggy dog. You ain't gotta put it on. Either or. If a girl really fucking with you, she really, you know, lustful and she really wants you and shit like that, she gonna let you go raw doggy dog for sure. But yeah, women in their body count, never trust it. Don't ask, who cares? You tell by their actions. So that's my first video. My second video, you know, like I said, this guy trying to be a player, he got caught up and the guy, oh, she say, I'm gonna get you back. Just watch. Let's watch the video.
Now what's up? Where the homeboy at?
What's up?
That's fine, cause I'ma call him. I'ma call him. They been waiting on you to f*** up.
Man.
Your homeboys ain't your friends.
Money.
Your homeboys ain't your friends. And I know the other one got more money than you. You know what? I'ma call him. That's fine, cause I'ma call him.
You got calls.
I'm gonna sit on that tonight.
You got calls.
Wow.
Oh.
Wow.
Yay.
Wow. Oh.
So what? This supposed to be.
Wow. Remember, you had to catch the bus to get here.
Ooh. And you got nothing that's about this?
Yeah,
they ain't got shit doing me, man.
And guess what else?
What?
You're gonna have to find somewhere to stay too, boo.
Okay, you gotta get kicked out the crisp. Stay down the curb.
Not on the list. So, that's what you wanna with. That's fine. Make sure you got a pallet. Hey, make sure you got a pallet.
You just stay with me.
Okay, man, in my opinion, once you get caught cheating, the relationship is basically over. I'm gonna tell you why. It's over for a few reasons. If you get caught cheating, you know, it's over for a few reasons. First of all, she'll never trust you. And we all know how human nature works. It could take a million years to gain someone's trust and you can lose it in a split second. She'll never trust you. Secondly, she's gonna want payback. Payback, yes, they gotta get payback because they don't know how long you've been doing this. Once you get caught cheating, they don't know how far this go back. You know, they can feel like you've been a cheater since y'all first start talking. So it's so hard to gain the trust back once you cheat on your guy. It is. It's over with because she gonna get you back at some point. And when she gets you, this is a female nature point. When she gets you, she gonna get you good. Yes. You see, she says she gonna cheat with his homeboy. I'm gonna chill with your homeboy. I'm gonna sit on that tonight. This is what women do. She's not lying. When women cheat on a guy or they wanna get a guy back, they'll get back at him with the guy that he has to see every day or even his friend or his brother, someone that he knows very well or someone he's very close to. This is how women get you back. Yes. Someone you have to look in the eye, you might have to shake their hand every day and knowing she did what she did and you have to look that man in the face and touch that man or do dealings with that man. This is what women do. So she's not capping when she say, oh, I'm gonna go chill with your friend, this and that. She gonna do that because this is what women do. And she's not lying when she say his homeboy's been waiting for him to slip up and, you know, fuck up. Yes, your homeboys do this. If you got a girl that she fine, she got body, this and that. These niggas ain't real out here. These niggas is plotting on your downfall. They can't wait till you fuck up. They want to hit your chick. Yes. Yes. These niggas ain't real out here. That's why you can only fuck with a couple of them. These dudes not real out here. They not. They waiting for you to mess up. She's not lying. They be in a DM. Talking about, oh, what you looking angry for? He not. You know, they try to say it in a way where it don't seem like they trying to flirt with your girl, but your boys are flirt with your girl. Or guys, you thought with your boy, flirt with your girl. So she's not lying. She's not lying. Guys will do this. This is a male nature thing. Men do this. When they friend, girl is fine, they be plotting, trying to, you know, be the cleanup man and shit like that without being in a relationship with her, trying to be a cleanup man. So she not lying. But guys, once the relationship is, you know, you cheated or she cheated, it's over with. It is. Because if she cheated, vice versa, she cheated, it's going to be back in your mind. How long has been going on? How long she been cheating? Who she cheating with? Is anybody else close to me she cheating with? Things like that. So it's over. Once somebody cheated, it's over. I'm not saying 100% of the time, but 99.9% of the time it's over. You might still have that 0.1% chance, but it's over with. It's over with. It's over with. Cut it. It's over with. The relationship is over with. Once you get caught cheating, then this is what women do. They just cheat with your best friend, your cousin, your brother. They won't get at someone that's very close to you. So great teaching points with both of these videos. I'm gonna start, you know, like I say, keep this going with reacting to two videos, because it's great teaching points with these videos. I can cover different areas and things like that. You can really get my view on, my perspective on how I view different things and different situations and things like that. So I'll have this coming more often. So comment, like, subscribe. Let me know what y'all think. You know, best way you can help is share the video, if it's entertaining, hit that Cash App. Keep it coming, baby. We out.